In this episode, we explore the most commonly used file formats in genomics and bioinformatics, like FASTA, FASTQ, BAM files, and VCF files. Hello, and welcome to another video in our series on genome data analysis. By the end of this video, you will have a solid understanding of what genomics data file formats contain, when and how they are generated, and how you can use them effectively in your analysis. The first and the most basic file you encounter when working in genomics is called a FASTA file. This format is widely used for storing sequencing data of nucleotides and proteins. Basically, a FASTA file is a simple text file with two main components. One, header line. This line begins with a greater than character, followed by a brief information on the sequence. So if you're working with the sequence of a single gene, the data in the header line should include the number of the chromosome, gene name, and the name of the organism. This should be similar in the case where you're looking at the sequence of a given protein as well. In addition, these files can also store the sequencing data of reference genome assemblies, in which case you will only have the chromosome number in the header line. 2. The sequence. The header line must be followed by the sequence of either nucleotides or amino acids in the next line. This sequence must be in plain text and does not include any spaces or special characters. In bioinformatics, these files can be used for various purposes including data alignment and annotation. The FASTQ file format is the typical format for storing sequencing data generated from a next-generation sequencing platform. It combines sequence data with quality information in a compact text-based format. So, if you're going to do the secondary analysis on a NGS data, in most cases, FASTQ files are your starting material. This format consists of 4 lines per each sequence, repeated for each read. These lines are the header line. This starts with the at symbol, followed by a unique identifier for the sequence. This identifier often includes additional metadata, like information about the sequencing machine or run. The sequence line. This consists of the actual nucleotide sequence represented by the usual 4 bases A, T, C, and G, and possibly others like N for ambiguous bases. The plus sign. This line is simply a separator. It may repeat the header or be left blank, depending on the file. The quality line. This line represents the quality score of the sequence in the same length as the sequence line. Each character corresponds to a quality score based on the ASCII table. Higher score means higher confidence in the base call. The ASCII table maps each character to a numeric value, starting with low scores like the exclamation mark for 0 and going up. For practice, you can find the ASCII table online and find what the quality of your FASTQ reads are. Most modern sequencing platforms use the FRED quality score, where each ASCII character corresponds to a score indicating the probability of a base call being incorrect. For example, a FRED score of 20 means a 1 in 100 chance of error, while a score of 30 means a 1 in 1000 chance of error. The FASTQ format is crucial because it pairs the sequence with its quality information, allowing researchers to assess the reliability of their data before downstream analysis. And it is also the important difference between a FASTQ file and a FASTA file. As I said before, a FASTA file only presents a header line and the DNA or protein sequence. This type of file only contains the raw information produced by sequencing machine. However, This file can later be aligned with a reference genome and create the next file that we are going to discuss. After alignment of the FASTQ file, based on how you have designed your alignment pipeline, you can have a SAN or BAM file. Basically, they both represent the same data with the same structure. But the main difference is that a BAM file is the binary version of a SAN file. SAN is a plain text file and because of that can amount to a large file, especially if you are working with whole genome sequencing data. The binary nature of BAM file can therefore reduce the file size. However, unlike SAN, for BAM you need special tools to be able to view the file, for example, SAN tools. In addition, as it is a large file, for performing further analysis on this file, for example, data visualization, you would require an index file, which is usually shown with a .bai extension. This file can help downstream tools better navigate the BAM file more easily. The data structure, as said before, is the same for SAM and BAM files. The header section. This is optional, but highly recommended. It contains metadata about the sequencing experiment, such as reference genome version, alignment softwares, and read group information. Each header line starts with an at symbol. The alignment section. This lists the aligned reads, one per line, and contains essential details like query name, which is the identifier for the read. Flag, a bitwise number encoding alignment properties such as whether the read is paired or unmapped. The reference name, which is the name of the reference chromosome. Position, which is the starting position of the read on the chromosome. Mapping quality, a score indicating the confidence of the alignment. Cigar string encodes the alignment details such as matches, insertion or deletions, and sequence and quality score, which showed the read sequence and its qualities similar to FASTQ file. A BAM file after several quality control and data cleaning measures can then enter a variant calling pipeline, through which a list of genetic alterations will be identified. The standard structure for storing a list of variants is called VCF or variant calling format. These files are compact, flexible, and essential for understanding the differences between a sample's genome and the reference genome. So let's break it down. A VCF file is divided into two main sections. The first one is the header. The header contains metadata about the file and begins with double hash. It includes details like the reference genome version, tools used for variant calling, and the structure of the data columns. Another important line is the column header, starting with a single hash, and it defines the fields in the data section. The data section includes the list of variants, one per line, with key details. The first column is called chrome, and it shows the chromosome where the variant is located. The second column is POS, and it shows the position of the variant on the chromosome. The third column is the ID column, and it brings a unique identifier for each variant. The fourth and the fifth columns are ref and alt, and they are the reference bases and the alternate alleles. The sixth column shows the quality score for each variant. And then you can see the filter column, which indicates whether the variant passed the quality threshold or not. Next, you will have the info column, which is a detail filled with additional information and annotations for each variant. And lastly, you will have two more columns. The format column includes the abbreviation defining the data brought in the last column, which is the sample information. In this column, you will find data like variant zygosity and various scores that represent the quality of genotypes or variant counts. Based on what you're looking for, VCF files can be used in various ways, but most commonly, especially in clinical fields, these files are annotated and enter the so-called tertiary analysis step. So, Now, you are familiar with the four most popular file formats used in genomics. During the secondary analysis of sequencing data, the four file formats, FASTA, FASTQ, SAM or BAM, and VCF, play distinct and sequential roles. The process begins with the FASTQ file, which contains raw sequencing reads and their quality scores generated by the sequencing machine. These reads are then aligned to a reference genome, which is in FASTA file format, producing a SAM file with detailed alignment information. The BAM file is the compressed binary version used for storage and processing efficiency. BAM files are further analyzed to identify generate variations through processes like variant calling, producing a VCF file, which catalogs the identified variants, including single nucleotide polymorphisms and insertions or deletions, or indels for short. In this video, you'll learn the fundamentals of these file formats. This information is crucial for an easier understanding of the secondary analysis step. And in our future videos, we will be talking about the secondary analysis step and popular pipelines used in genomic data analysis. So until next time, keep exploring the wonders of science and take care.